In the Brock and the Hard Play segment tonight, let's get right to Crowley and Combs, who have been listening closely to Senator Rubio. Combs, fair interview with Sarah?
I mean, you covered a lot of ground. I thought you were fair. You had some questions about, or more questions on Benghazi than perhaps the AT issue, and I thought the questioning was good, and I thought that he was fair, too.
Now, the Obama administration promised, the president promised, that he was going to be transparent when he came into office. Is transparent? All this chaos? Is
I'd like to believe there's more transparency in this administration.
I would like
more transparency. We've got a whole series of things I wish there was more transparency about.
Because you know the ruse, as I told the senator, it's we want to find out what happened. We're going to find out. Jay Carney today, you couldn't watch it. You just wanted to go and with a fly swatter. Okay? We'll find out, but and they don't find out.
You have to admit, there's certainly an agenda against Hillary.
I will admit that. And I did in the talking points memo. Okay? And they're hurting those people who, you know, everything's a scandal, everything's Watergate. They heard it because they give President Obama cover. Now, I'm going to direct this question to you.
Okay.
Do you agree with that? Do you agree with certain people who despise President Clinton and Hillary Clinton so much, President Obama and Hillary Clinton so much, that everything is a scandal, everything is Watergate? We don't even know the facts about the AP thing yet. But it's already, they're coming for us. They're going to arrest me, you, and Combs. Probably not Combs. And me and you, we're going to be arrested and put in cuffs. Do you agree that the president cover?
Well, giving him cover is a separate issue. What the press has done and what Obama and Hillary have done over many years is create cults of personality. And with the protection of the press, both Hillary and President Obama... ...without having to perform, Bill. Okay. And when they screw up, they don't get nailed.
I'm going to reframe my question because this is a serious question that I want you to answer. Many people get mad at me because I tell them I cannot speculate. I have to deal with facts. However, on talk radio where you live, all right, there's a lot of speculation, and you guys can do it. That's what you do. When I was talking on radio, I did it. But it hurts the cause of people who do believe the Obama administration is corrupt to throw out all of these unsubstantiated charges.
Unsubstantiated is one thing. When you have a core of facts, whether it's on Benghazi,
Tell me what we have on the IRS that links it to President Obama.
We don't have anything that links him directly yet, but this is at the very beginning of the story.
And it should be investigated thoroughly.
And so the conversation is, as it was with President Nixon, as it was with President Clinton, do we have a pattern of behavior that shows us an abuse of power?
And that's what Rubio pointed out. There is a pattern of behavior. Is there not?
Yes, but the question also is, how high up does the pattern go? Does it extend to the Secretary of State? Does it extend to the President? Where do you draw the line? Now, the investigation that Pickering did, along with Mike Mullen...
Stop with the Pickering business.
I'd say, well, I had Thomas Pickering, the ambassador who co-chaired the Accountability Review Board with the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, Mike Mullen, who said that there was absolutely nothing that went untoward here in terms of the time they could not get help to Benghazi quickly enough.
Let me understand what you're saying. Sure. You had Secretary Clinton, but you didn't ask her any questions, and why not?
Because, in fact, we knew where the responsibility rested. She had already stated on a number of occasions she accepted, as a result of her job, the full responsibility.
That's the biggest joke in the world. And this is the guy you're pointing to justify your thing?
He pointed out, when I interviewed him, that it rested in two places. The Department of Mideast Affairs and the Bureau of Diplomatic Security.
Why would we take him seriously on anything if he doesn't even ask the pertinent questions to Hillary Clinton?
He should have interviewed Hillary Clinton.
That's right.
I'm telling you that he actually pointed to the Bureau of Diplomatic Security and the NEA
and
the
places where he thought
the crux was
of the problem. But he didn't want to go any higher, correct?
Look, you cannot just accept all of the glory of your office, whether it's the presidency or the Secretary of State job, and not accept the crap when the crap comes down. Crap is coming down right on Hillary Clinton's head. The buck has to stop somewhere. It's got to start with the person in charge.
Let me sum this up so even Holmes can understand.
Talk slowly.
Okay, I will. They won't answer any questions, Holmes. Holder won't answer them. Yeah. Hillary won't answer them. And the president.
Hillary testified before Congress.
Yeah, I know.
She did.
And they booted it.
All Hillary had to do was
come in here. All she has to do is come in here and we'll clean it right up.
All right.
She
did testify.